Hey there and welcome to Workflowy. Just a couple of minutes, I'll teach you the basics, all you need to know to get started. So the first thing you'll notice is that we have these little bullet points here. And to add information to Workflowy, you just start typing. Or we could also paste our information by creating a new item and then hitting Control V or Command V. And it's going to add each individual item as a bullet point in our account. Now, something really important about Workflowy is that you'll notice we don't have any folders, we don't have any pages, and we don't have any documents. Workflowy is one single outline, so the way that we organize information is by indenting and outdenting information. For example, let's say these are two tasks that I want to put somewhere so I know that they're tasks. The way that I would do that is move my cursor to the start of the line, hit enter to create a new bullet point, and then give it a name, something like tasks. Next, I will move my cursor down to these items here, and I'll hit tab to indent it, and I'll move down to this next one, and again, I'll hit tab. I could also do the same thing for multiple items by selecting them with my cursor. And in this case, I'm going to outdent them using Shift Tab. That's how we outdent items. And so this is how you can modify multiple items at the same time. So I'm going to select both of these, hit Tab, and now they're indented. So when we indent items in a workflow, it doesn't just move them over to the right visually. It also means that they now belong as children of the item that they're indented under. So now these two items are actually part of tasks. And that means we can do a couple of interesting things with them. First of all, we can actually zoom into tasks now by simply clicking the bullet point for tasks. We'll zoom in and now we only see the items that are indented under tasks. So you could consider this to be how you create either documents or folders inside of Workflowy. And there's no limit to how far we can indent something. So for example, I could now move to the end of the line, hit enter to create a new bullet, hit tab to indent it. And let's say I want to remember to take out trash in the kitchen and the bathroom. And if I now click on take out the trash, again, we'll zoom in another level and we'll only see the items that are nested under take out the trash. And each time we zoom in, we can always know where we are in our account by looking at the breadcrumbs we have in the menu bar. So for example, we are in take out the trash, which is under tasks, which is at the very top of our account, which is what this little home icon represents. And we can zoom out by simply clicking any of these. So let's say I want to zoom out one level. I just click on tasks. Or if I ever want to zoom out all the way out, I just click on the home icon. Also, whenever we have nested items such as these, we get this little triangle toggle that allows us to either hide or display the information that's nested under it. So we can very easily now hide all the information about our tasks and only see everything else that isn't collapsed. I'll go ahead and now create another section here called notes and show you another feature that we have when we indent items. I'm going to take these two items here just by highlighting them and hit tab to nest them. It's another part of this item right here. And so I can actually move everything that's nested under an item by simply clicking and dragging the bullet point that holds it. For example, this one right here holds these items. So not only can I click the triangle to hide and expand the information, I can also click and drag to move everything together, including the item and the items that are nested under it. So now I will move this item right here. And as you can see, when I click and drag these bullet points, we get a horizontal bar that allows us to see exactly where we're going to drop it. So that allows us to not only move things around, we can also indent items this way. So if I drop this item here, where the line is very long, I'm going to put it on the same level as tasks and notes. But if I move it slightly over to the right, now it's going to be indented under tasks, and it'll actually put it inside, as you can see with that animation. So I'll open it up and move it back to where I want it. So this is how we can very quickly move items around in Workflowy by simply clicking and dragging around the bullet points anywhere we want. We can move a bunch of information very quickly. So I'll move this back up here. Next, we have a bunch of different options to format the text. It's not just bullet points. If I highlight any piece of text like this right here, I get a text format widget that allows me to change it into a heading, turn it into a paragraph, which will hide the bullet point, give it bold, italic, and a bunch of other different options. So I'm going to turn this into a heading. And I can also change the color of the text or give it a highlight. Again, by just selecting the text. And then this last option here allows me to choose the color of the text or give it a highlight. So now I will zoom out for just a moment, create a new section called links, indent this right there. And now I've quickly organized all the information that I put into my account. So because everything is part of one single outline, that means our search functionality in Workflowy is really powerful. And here we are zoomed out all the way to the very top of our account. And so when we perform a search, it's going to search across our entire account. The search is going to happen in real time, and any matches are going to be automatically highlighted. This is not just a passive search that shows us the results. We can actually modify and play with any of the results in real time. So if I wanted to search for this because I wanted to add an additional piece of information, I could do that. And then when I remove the search, that information is saved. Now I'm going to show you where you're going to find most of the other features inside Workflowy. The first one being the bullet menu. And you can find the bullet menu when we hover over any item in Workflowy. You'll notice this little icon right here as I hover over it. If I click it, it allows me to turn this item and give it a different format. I could even turn this list of bullets into a Kanban board if I prefer, or turn this item right here into a heading, or turn it into a to-do. In addition, this is where we can do all kinds of other things, including completing the item, adding a date, performing actions like moving it to a different part of our account, uploading a file, and a bunch of other things, including accessing the various sharing options that we have available. Now, the second way we have to quickly perform actions and format things in Workflowy is by using the slash menu. So as long as we have a space in between the last bit of text, we type slash and we have access to a bunch of different options, including formatting options and different commands by simply moving our arrow keys and choosing the item or typing the name of the command. So for example, if I wanted to move this item right here, I can now hit enter and I can move it somewhere, let's say the link section. So if you're curious about all the different things you can do in Workflowy, exploring the slash command is a great way to quickly find out all the different things you can do without having to use your mouse. And lastly, I'll show you where you can access the settings. We move to the menu bar on the top right-hand side under the More menu. And if we click on that, we have a bunch of different options, but the one we're looking for is right here, which is settings. And here is where we can add a name to our account, change our email, or even set a password if we don't want to use the email code login. You can also do things like change the appearance or the font or modify a couple of the styling options. And if you're interested, you could also enable more experimental features by scrolling down to the feature section, toggling Workflowy Labs, which will give you access to even more features that you might find useful. And if you want to learn about more of the features that Workflowy has available, be sure to check out workflowy.com/learn. And if you have any questions, feel free to email us at help@workflowy.com.